Hi, and welcome to Community with me, Melissa Sanfield. I have some great people in this studio today. I'm so excited. I have a room full of people, and then I have a party of one sitting right next to me. So we're going to talk about a lot of different things. We have so many talents in the room today, and I'm just going to facilitate the things that they're doing at this time and what they do as their specialty in life. So I'm not even going to take a break. We're going to go right into it. And we're going to introduce you to a singer. He is dubbed the Entertainer. And his name is Alonzo. I'd like to welcome you.
How's it going? Welcome.
Welcome, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. I'm so glad you came. You're a friend of Cynthia, who actually is here today again. She can always come back. And she's sending me a lot of great people, and she sent me you. So tell us about what you do.
I am a singer, songwriter, do a little producing, we do a lot of shows, I do a little acting, I do a little modeling, if you couldn't tell. No, just kidding. Basically, I'm just your all-around entertainer.
Wow, and that's good, because nowadays, a lot of people just specialize in one thing.
Can't do that anymore.
Yeah, because we remember, like, Sammy Davis Jr., he could sing, he could tap. Act, mm-hmm. everything. So it's very good. So how old are you now, and when did you start?
I'm 23 years old now.
Oh, wow.
Started doing this professionally when I was about 18. At that time, I started off solo, and then shortly after, I got into a group by the name of Glasshouse with me and my partner, and we did that for a few years. Traveled all over the city of LA and all over Southern California, basically.
Wow.
Did a lot of nonprofit gigs and a lot of stuff with the cities.
Right.
We did some stuff for BET.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm just kind of transitioning to a solo career and a more adult, sound and image.
Right. Well, what about, I think anyone that would listen to you would want to know, how did you find your voice? Like, how did you know you can sing, and this is what you wanted to do?
Actually, my father and my uncle, which is my bandmates, his dad, they were both singers. So basically, when we were growing up all around the house, they're singing Jodeci and they're singing Silk and all these other groups and Drew Hill. And it was kind of like in the house. So just naturally... it was always something that was in my mind. And
well, I sing all around too, but I wouldn't go in public and sing. So how did you know you had enough talent to actually go? Like, I can't even do karaoke. I clear a room when I do karaoke. So how did you know, like, you had it, where you could go out and share it with the world?
I think through church, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 18, I immediately had gotten to church. And at that time, a little bit before then, I had gotten to performing arts school. And in performing arts school, they would kind of try to fill us out and see what our niche was.
Right.
And I sang, and when I sang, my teacher at the time was just blown away. And she was just like, your voice is something special. And, I felt like it was really genuine. I didn't feel like she was just gassing me and blowing smoke, So that's when I kind of felt like, okay, well, maybe I can do this.
Right. And then you have enough confidence, it looks like.
Now I do.
So you were shy before?
I was very coy, I guess you could say. Never shy, but I've grown into being confident as I am now.
Right. So. Oh, cool. Well, do we have any of Alonzo's music queued up? Well, we'll cue up some of your music. And what is it like that you like to do? Like, out of all those things, what's your favorite thing to do? Is it really singing?
It's just art in general. I do love to sing, but I always tell people I'm not a vocalist.
Right.
I'm an artist, and there's a difference. There's some people that can blow the roof off the building, but they have to have somebody writing for them, or they have to have somebody producing. Or I'm really an all around creator.
Right.
I enjoy creating a project from start to finish, creating a concept and really bringing it to life. So that includes acting out the project or singing in the project or dancing in the project, which I'm horrible at.
You can't dance?
I'm like all
bad. You can
sing,
but you can't dance?
A little. I could two-step.
So what do you do on the stage? Or you said it was a different type of music.
I've tried the dancing. We danced when we went to BET. Hilarious. You don't want to see that.
Oh, wow.
Let's put it just archived away somewhere.
So you just kind of, okay, we'll try to look up something and see if we can find you dancing.
So now,
I'd like
I
to
mean,
see that.
No dancing now. It's just more about the music and about the feel, and I want to try to focus on bringing back like that 90s R&B, mm-hmm. you know, when you used to turn on the radio and there was like Jagged Edge
right.
and Donnell Jones and Ginuwine. Mm-hmm. And nowadays there's really nobody doing it with the exception of maybe like, you know, Miguel.
Right.
But I want to really tap into that and kind of cater towards that audience who's been missing out for a while.
At 23, which group is your focus? You know what I mean? Like mm-hmm. what's your target group? Because I'm not ashamed to say I'm 44. So who would you be singing to? Like people your age, or would it just be like in something in general? Where if it's just a love song, it's if you're in love.
Exactly, and you hit it on the head. It's basically I feel like people are trying to focus on a specific group, and mm-hmm. everybody knows what love is. Do you know? Even if it's a friend to a friend, a 5-year-old, you know, loves
right.
their best friend. So a lot of my music is love music, mm-hmm. love inspired. So my general target would be probably from about 16 and up.
Right.
You know, a lot of my subject matter is a little more adult, so I'm mm-hmm. not going to be promoting, you know, for the 12-year-old to be listening
right,
to
right.
you know, a story about a one-night stand.
Oh. Okay. Do you have it queued up, Mr. LaRon? Okay, so we're going to listen. Do we know which song this is?
This is my latest single. I just released a video for it this morning.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, this is my latest single. It's called Everything You Need, and the song is basically about a one-night stand turned love affair gone wrong. And, yeah, you're looking at me like I'm crazy.
No, that's real life stuff.
It's real life. You know,
sometimes somebody's experiencing that.
One night and, you know, never see that person again. But then at a point in time, you're like, hey, I'm kind of feeling you. And this might should go on for more than just a night.
Right.
So
oh, I get that.
It's about one of those type of situations. And, you know.
And we're going to talk about where we can see the video. Let's listen to it. And then we're going to talk about where we can see the video because I want to write that down.
So I gotta be the one you need. Just let me be the one you need. Hey, tell me what I gotta do to get you to see. There's no I know you, baby, and me. So I gotta be the one you need. Just let me be the one you need.
We were all in here grooving. I was doing a lot of talking, but I also listened. I did like the music. I liked the beat. It was something, you know, I'm a head bobber. I like to bob my head. So I was bobbing my head to it nice and smooth, like you say, for the adult crowd, definitely. And it's relatable, you know. So I commend you on that. Good job. Good job.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So where are we able to find the video and find you and give us all your info?
Right now, you can find the video exclusively on YouTube. You just search Alonzo with a Z, everything you, the letter U, everything you need. Mm-hmm. Or you can find it on Facebook. You can find it on my official artist Facebook page, which is Alonzo the Entertainer.
Okay.
Or you can find me on Instagram at Alonzo Direct. Once again, that's Alonzo with a Z. Okay. Alonzo Direct. And that's pretty much, those are the two main places where I'm at right now. I'm not a big social media head, but, you know, the way things go, gotta be.
It kind of comes, you know, it gets bigger. As you grow, it will grow.
Yeah.
That's what I'm finding out with people. Like, I don't know. I have a Twitter account. I think I have like 3 followers. So maybe if I do something exciting.
You're right behind me with 5.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I finally found somebody that's like in the single
don't
digits like myself.
All.
I think as you grow, and I'm sure you will, that your following and your media, social media expertise will grow along with that, because that's kind of the way people are maintaining, you know, who they're dealing with and who
absolutely
really is listening
true.
To them,
I used
right?
to feel like, oh my God, who has time to do this every day? I mean, I was like doing school and doing
right.
music and doing all this other stuff. I'm
right.
like, I do not have time to be sitting here telling you, hey, I'm in the bathroom.
Right. I'm about to eat.
Yeah, I'm about to eat something. Here go a picture of it right here. You know?
Oh, that's
Kentucky
so funny.
But I guess you just got to make time.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think that everything you're doing is great. And for you to be so young, I love it when young people come here. Not like I'm all old, but I love when young people come, and it inspires me, you know, to do more. And then, of course, I here in our community, we embrace our youth, especially when they're doing something positive. And my heart always pitter patters a little bit harder when I see a young man. I'm not going to say any color because it doesn't matter to me which color you are, but any young man doing something great, you know, it really makes me feel good. So we're going to take a little break, and we'll be back with Alonzo, and he'll give us some closing remarks. And then we have Cynthia and the gang. They're going to come on after Alonzo and I are done chatting with you all. We'll be right back.
Came crashing down on me.
Jamming to Stephanie Mills and Alonzo said I can sing,
she
y'all.
She can sing, but, y'all. Mm-mm. She playing around.
Mm-mm. I cannot sing, but well, speaking of comfort zone, we're talking about the comfort of a man. So you recently lost your comfort zone. Tell us about that.
Recently, as about a year and a half ago. Me and my group mate, we had decided to basically change our group into like a conglomerate,
right,
which is basically like a Young Money into like a crew.
Right.
So we stopped performing together exclusively, and now we do a lot more. We do a lot more solo projects and a lot more different solo ventures.
Mm-hmm.
So it's been really different because mm-hmm. you know how it is when you have somebody that you work with, mm-hmm. and if I forget something, he always remembers it. Or
right.
I, you know, I'm forgetting the words up there. He's saying them like, oh,
right.
this is what the words are.
Right.
So it's really different when you have to just rely strictly on yourself
mm-hmm.
and, you know, don't consult with anybody. Nobody's there to give you any feedback on
right.
if something is good or if this is whack or, you know, so it's really different.
And then sometimes you have people around you that say you're good and
yes,
you're like, oh, no, that wasn't that good.
No,
you know what
yes
I mean?
No yes men allowed.
No yes men allowed. So you've changed your comfort zone and you're out of your safety zone. So
there
how is it treading water alone?
It's very different because by myself, I feel I have a little bit more of an obligation to cater to more of an adult audience. Mm-hmm. So this is something that I had never done in musically, really, throughout the entire 2 or 3, 4 years that we had been performing together. Everything was kind of, you know, Disney friendly, very PC.
Right.
So now it's kind of like it's adult. And like I said, I was talking, you know, I'm talking about, you know, relationships and sex and different stuff, like grown up topics. So it's sometimes it's a little uncomfortable for me, and I have to be like, okay, wait a minute, I'm grown, I could talk about this, you know, but it's just so different transitioning out of working and always having that in the back of your mind, like, okay, don't say this because this is not appropriate for this age group or this particular constituency of people.
Right.
So it's really different, I'm getting comfortable.
Yeah, I can see. So which current projects do you have, you know, right now?
Right now, I'm actually working on, when you go to YouTube and search Alonzo, Everything You Need, you'll see the video is a to be continued. I'm actually working on the second half of that video, and I've already shot in May. I've already shot another video to the follow-up, which is like completely a different direction, like an alternative type of R&B, crazy and just different. And I like to try to keep it fresh. So I have a couple of different singles that are coming following this one, and a couple of different videos going after that one. So that's what I'm working on right
really
now.
Really versatile, then.
Yeah, try to be as versatile as possible, but you know, keep it to where it's not alienating anybody.
I understand that.
So that's what I'm working on right now.
Okay, well, it's been an absolute delight having you here.
It's been an honor and a pleasure being here with you as well.
Do you have any closing remarks or anything you'd like for the listeners and the viewers to know?
I would definitely, 3 things. I would love to give shout-outs to everybody that worked and supported me with this video and the other video projects, including my filmographer, co-director, Aaron Clark, Jessica Clark helped with makeup, my co-star, she did an excellent job. Shout-outs to her, Andrea. I want to give a shout-out to Dumpsick Entertainment. That's one of the recording groups that that records my music, and they have been working with me from day one. They're awesome, great. And just a big shout-out to the fans, big shout-out to the supporters. I know over time, you know, in between projects, people's attention span is short. So people have been knocking at my door like, when are you gonna put the next project out? When are you going to put the next project out? So just for the continuance of support, I'm just immensely grateful and thankful to all of the fans and the supporters. And this everything that I do is for you guys.
Oh, cool. Well, thank you.
Thank you very
much.
Thank you for having me.
So we had a great time speaking with Mr. Alonzo the Entertainer, and he's welcome to come back anytime someone comes into this community. They are my friend. You didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
But now he's my friend, so he's able to come back whenever he gets ready, whenever he wants to come back, have something new going on, and then maybe we can leave out with, can we show a piece of his video? I keep throwing stuff at LaRon today. We can't. Okay, well, we'll show his video. I'll make it a point to show his video. When will I show it, LaRon? One day?
He said one day soon.
We'll show it tonight. We'll upload it between all the changes and the breaks and stuff, and we want to look at a piece of that video and give you guys a nice treat. We have a recording artist here today, so, and I'm appreciative. And we'll be right back with Cynthia and the gang. They're going to be right here. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
When I think of home, I think of a resting place. A place where there's peace, quiet, and serenity. And that's where some of my friends have gone. Friends who have traveled with me through my wonderful experience in Oz. A journey when I think of home, I think of a place where there's love overflowing. I wish I was home, I wish I was back there with the things I've been knowing. When night makes the tall grass, so
I'm like so relaxed. I just got like the best massage during this break, and I'm not even gonna really go into it right now. I'm just feeling really, really good and blessed and honored to have so many great people here with me. I have my brand new friend who is now my forever friend, and she knows about the rule of being my friend, and we've been in touch since we met through Rolanda Freeman, and she is Cynthia Billingsley. Welcome, welcome again.
Thank you, Melissa. Thank you for having me again.
You have a great event going on this Sunday, and yes, the community, I mean, my community will be there with you to celebrate.
Awesome.
So tell us, tell us all about it, and then you can introduce your supporting cast.
Okay, awesome. It's our annual women's luncheon. It's called, actually, the annual girlfriends luncheon, where we invite hundreds of women to come out and celebrate each other, give back to the community with charitable givings, and also just to come and have a good time.
Right.
We have comedian Angel host, Angel Gaines.
Cool.
She's going to host the event.
Cool.
We have a Relief and Belief owner, Rodney Burnell.
Right.
He's
going to
give all the people great massages, whoever wants one, and even some chair massages and foot massages. We have DJ Strick, who's going to be on the Wheels of Steel. And we're going to have Brianna's here from Dream Girl Salon. She's a representative here, and her salon is going to rock the runway with the other stylists. And we're going to have some motivational words from the owners, Sherry and Tanya, the Thompson sisters.
Oh, cool. So everyone, say a few words. Let's get talking
Thank you. First of all, thank you for having me.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
I'm so honored to be a part of your radio show. I love it. We were just jamming to Stephanie Mills, honey, because she was taking me back. But anyway, so this event is going to be so spectacular. This is actually my fourth year hosting.
Mm.
So we have a great...
Oh,
thank you. So, you know, we have a great time every time, and I'm just so proud of this sold out. So if you didn't get your tickets, you better start looking for it for next year.
Because
And the women come, and we have such a great time. Cynthia just rolls out the red carpet. You leave with this amazing gift bag. You know, the Oscars think they have a gift bag. But Cynthia hooks it up, honey. I use all of my products and contacts, and, you know, and that's how... I met these wonderful gentlemen here. DJ Strick can, you know, turn a party out. And
right,
we just walk the runway. And, you know, the way that she lays out the program is so much fun. It's not just a luncheon, but it's, like, empowering. It's entertaining. So when you come, it's really a really big treat. And then she also has vending. So you can bring your credit cards, honey, and leave with two, three outfits, a handbag, you know, some new holistic products. And the vendors that she used, are they all have quality, amazing products. So you really form relationships and bonds. So, you know, and that's how I met this great guy with over the massage therapist over here, Rodney.
He has me, like, on cloud nine.
Isn't he amazing? You know, he actually, because of this networking, I'm a school teacher as well, as a comedian. And Rodney has been to my school to massage the teachers for a teacher wellness day.
Awesome.
So he's amazing. Like, once you make, because Cynthia is so great with putting people together, and it's almost like, I almost want to ask Cynthia, do you like only want quality people in your life? I mean, nobody's shabby. I'm like, Cynthia, do you know any shabby people in your life? She has no shabby, low quality friends.
She sent Alina last week and Corlin, and then she sent one of the ladies we didn't connect. I think her name was Anitra, I believe.
Uh-huh.
We didn't connect yet, but she's coming.
Okay.
And then Alonzo was my Cynthia Billingsley hookup.
Right.
I'm gonna start calling it the Cynthia Billingsley hookup, because that's what it is. I mean, she comes in and she's doing great things for the community, which we share that sisterhood right there. Like, it's nothing like it when you meet someone else that gives like you give, or she gives actually like I want to give. Let's say that, because she gives a lot and she gives her time.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do things outside of what you're just supposed to do or what you think you should do, then you're a heck of a person. And so we're going to just, in all fairness, move on to the next gentleman, and who was a great masseuse, I must say.
Thank you. My name is Rodney Brunell, and I'm the owner of Relief and Belief Body Works. I've had the pleasure of knowing Cynthia for like 8 years. I started with her at the first Hey Girlfriend Network. I seen it come from the start all the way up to the beginning, but always seen her vision that to bring a color of women together and to lead them with empowering words and self-motivation. And I'm just glad to be a part of it, to provide pampering, because my sisters are always givers, but they never let someone give them. So I'm just glad to be a part of her team and being a part of this group to bring on a great show. And now, Melissa, you now have a personal massage therapist. I'm Melissa's personal massage therapist.
Y'all.
She has a gift certificate, so she's going to come for a full pampering day for me.
He didn't fill it in the amount, y'all. I might fill it in.
Unlimited services.
Unlimited, right.
Yes, it is. Unlimited.
That is great. I always get really nice gifts when people come, and I love to do it, but I would do it even without getting the gifts because we want to highlight people here. We want to highlight the great things that are going on. You turn on the news, all bad news. Right. But here in this community, we'll talk about some things that are pretty tough sometimes. But for the most part, we're going to highlight businesses. We're going to highlight people. And we're going to highlight free massages today. Yes. So that's a great thing. So we want to, we're going to come back around to everyone. But we still like for everyone to introduce, we want to introduce DJ Extraordinaire there.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, my name is John Strickland. I go by the name of DJ Strick. I'm the owner operator of Strickly Entertainment, a mobile DJ company. And I've been with Cynthia since pretty much the inception of this thing, and I've seen it evolve and grow. And it's been a great pleasure to know Cynthia. I've met a lot of people, got a lot of business referrals as a result of working with Cynthia. And like I say, what she's doing is great, bringing women together as a whole, give them an opportunity to kind of bond and without the cattiness, they can have lunch and they can shop and meet new people and just have an overall great experience. So all I can say is I'm blessed to have Cynthia in my life and to be a part of this luncheon. Be a part of this luncheon.
Yeah, that happens up in here sometimes. Yeah, that's great. It's very nice to meet you. You guys look like you color coordinated a little bit there.
It wasn't planned. It wasn't by design. Yeah.
Red, orange, yellow.
Yes. That's what I'm asking the Jester to wear something red, orange, yellow.
I like that. Okay. Great minds think alike.
So they
liked it. Okay. And then we're in a kind of awkward position, but I have another young lady over there by name of
Brianna
Curry. Please introduce yourself. The camera can see you.
Hi. I'm here on behalf of Dream Girl Salon. We're located in Culver City. The owners, the Thompson sisters, again, they're going to be speaking at this year's event, and we also have an exciting hair show that we're going to do. The sisters weren't able to come today, so I'm here on their behalf. We're located, again, in Culver City. We specialize in hair extensions and healthy hair care, so we're going to highlight that at this year's show. If you want your hair to grow, if you're tired of wearing the same look, you'll see a lot of fun looks, versatile looks at this year's event. So
cool. So before I go any further, give us your website. I want everyone to give their information.
Okay. It's heygirlfriendnetwork.com, or you can reach me on Facebook, Hey Girlfriend Network.
Okay.
Okay. And I am www.angelgaines.com, and you can find me on Facebook, Angel Gaines.
Okay. And?
You can find me on Facebook, Rodney Brunell, and reliefandbelief.com.
Okay.
You can find me at www.djstrick@strictlyentertainment.com or DJ Strick on Facebook.
Okay.
And you can find our salon at www.dghair.com or on Facebook at facebook.com/dghair.
Oh, cool. Okay. That's really important since we're here. Mm-hmm. We want you to, even if you get one phone call, that's a good thing. You know, we want to make sure we network. At least I can say, oh, now I know a comedian. Now I know a masseuse, a massage therapist, because I didn't really know one before. But now I have a great DJ, and now I have someone who does great hairstyles. Right. So, I mean, of course, you're the queen of networking, apparently.
It is.
So, I mean, we're talking about 380 people sold out. And I was like, Cynthia, can I come? She's like, mm-mm. And I was like, Cynthia, I was like, I won't even have to eat. She was like, mm-mm, sold out. I was like, capacity. Cynthia. Right. Then she came, and I was like, but Cynthia. And I just start begging and pleading. And I was like, but Cynthia. And she said, well. And I said, what if I bring my radio show? And she said, I'll think about it. So I think I'm coming Sunday to work, but I'm a slide. Somebody, one of y'all need to open that back door for me.
Okay, exactly. But you know, I just want to let you know too, in case you're not able to get in, you can see me perform. I have another show on August 9th with First AME Church of Los Angeles. It's going to be August 9th, and the show is going to be amazing. It's with Lester Berry, Vince D, myself, and TJ McGee, and Shawn Michael. So that's Saturday, August 9th at 4 p.m. at Fame.
Okay.
So, yeah, because I do clean comedy.
That's what I was going to say. It has to be clean if you do it in a church.
Yeah, honey. It's called the Gospel Comedy Explosion.
Oh, wow.
So,
I mean, that's tickets for that.
They're only $10. They're only $10.
So, you can buy them at the door.
You can, I know that Angela is selling tickets, and so let me give you her number.
Okay.
It's 213. 924-9070, and you can contact her for tickets. Because I feel bad that the Girlfriend Network is sold out and a lot of listeners won't be able to come see me. Not that, you know, it's all about me, but you know what I'm saying? It could be.
But I guess I'll be in her shadow somewhere.
But let's all hook you up, girl. Just get there early and dress like a waiter or something. I'll get you in. You know?
Well, the big thing that that piggybacks on this that should be highlighted are the blessing bags the gift bags.
Right, the hygiene bags.
Yes. And tell us a little bit about those bags, Ms. Cynthia.
Well, this year we're going to ask each guest to bring 3 to 5 items of hygiene kits, something that that will make a hygiene kit. So, like, this one has soap, toothpaste, toothbrush, deodorant, and lotion. So we're going to try and get at least 500 kits, and we're going to donate them to the Downtown Women's Center on Skid Row so they can distribute them to those in need. So every year at the luncheon, we try and give back to the community with something. Last year, I believe
it was school supplies.
School supplies. Mm-hmm. Before it was canned goods. So this year is hygiene kits.
And I even told her I bring 10 hygiene products. She's like, mm-mm, you can drop them off, but you still can't no ticket. I was like, Cynthia, I mean, what else do I have to do? So I think I'm going to be in the house, y'all. But this is something Cynthia and I actually, I don't know if we're sharing a brain, but I had done this on a small scale for Father's Day. I went to Skid Row with packages just like this. But it's so hard to get people to go to Dollar Tree and spend $1, $2, $3, $4, $5. Right. Mm-hmm. And you get a whole bag. Mm-hmm. These are gallon size Ziploc bags. You can get a bunch of those for $1. Mm-hmm. And then just spend $10 and make 2 bags for people. It's such a great thing to do. And the people that you give them to are so appreciative.
Yes.
And we're able to take baths, and we take these things for granted and brush our teeth every day. And when I gave out my toothpaste downtown, I had a couple fighting over the toothpaste.
Wow.
No, I want it. No, I mean, and I just, we would never have enough. So for you to have 380 of these is going to make such a big impact in the lives of those women and children. And it's a never ending struggle with homelessness. And, you know, the basic thing you want to do is when you speak to someone is, you know, have fresh breath, things like that. So anyone else want to say anything? Y'all just help y'all.
Well, I'll say something since my breath is fresh.
She made that a requirement in her life. Like, you speak to somebody, you need fresh breath. So, you know, Cynthia, I think I'm doing okay. But yeah, I just want to say that, you know, please make sure you go to the website, you know, the Hey Girlfriend Network website, because she does wonderful things all throughout the year. And I know that there is some giving, because you do the coat drive during Christmas time. And so she's constantly working. I don't know if you want to talk a little bit about your website. So
well, basically do Facebook, because I'm like all over Facebook daily with different information that I can update on a regular. So, yeah, definitely join my Facebook page, Hey Girlfriend Network. And I post things about jobs, social services, housing, just whatever there's a need. And I will promote your you want to promote as well.
Because what's amazing is every time I have something, I get excited when I see Cynthia repost it. I'm like, that means that 11,000 people have seen this. Because she knows like everybody. Wow. And when you come to Hey Girlfriend Network Luncheon, you're bound to meet at least one celebrity.
Wow.
It's like Cynthia knows everybody. I'm waiting for next year. Probably be Obama.
Wow.
She just so, you know, well connected. So,
anyone on the other side? We don't want to leave y'all out.
Yes.
No, I'm good. You go ahead, Bob.
Oh, I just like to say I'm here to support Cynthia again, and my whole goal is to relieve people from stress, and that's one of the things that I've noticed in throughout our, like you said, looking at the news is stressful in our everyday. So working with Cynthia at Hey Girlfriend, it's something refreshing.
Right.
When you leave there, if you leave there sad, you're probably dead. You're probably dead. But I've never seen nobody leave there with a bad attitude. I've never seen nobody have a bad spirit. And even I've seen people come there that not feeling it, but when they leave, there's a different outlook. So.
And talk about you just recently did the Grammys this
year. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yay.
I just did the.
I
just did the Oscar Awards. I provided massages at the Oscar Awards. So. That was a great experience, and I do a lot of traveling. I work for UCLA. I do men's and women's track, so I do sports massage, and I'm a holistic massage therapist. So my goal is to reorganize the body through mind, spirit, and soul through massage therapy, which nobody understands if I give you a pill, that stops the pain.
Right.
But if I can start from the inside out and release those bondages and those things that are a stronghold, then you're healed and you're able to move on. So that's where I am mm-hmm. with massage therapy and trying to just spread it around the world. Mm-hmm.
And I'm also a client of his. And let me tell you something. He does breakup massages. I broke up with a boyfriend, honey. He rubbed that pain right on out me. Yes, he is therapeutic, honey. Yes.
Will the massage help you get a man?
No, here's the thing about massage, because if you have negative energy, that's my job to restore the positive energy. Mm-hmm. And that's why I say about massage therapy, we go along with, we have so, like Erykah Badu, Bag Lady. The song is bag mm-hmm. because we're carrying so much baggage.
Yeah.
So if I let go of this bag and I let go of this bag, now it's getting a little lighter. Now mm-hmm. I can think, I can manipulate, I can do whatever I want to do. But
right.
if you have a lot of baggage, you can't think properly. So that's my job. I tell my clients, you're like a blackboard with stress on it, and it's my job to erase it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. A good concept.
He does a great job. Good he does a great job. Yeah.
And DJ, how do you relieve stress? No, I'm just kidding.
Basically, like I said before, piggybacking off him, it's just a pleasure to be a part of this team. And like I said, I'm the musical arm of it, and it brings me pleasure when I see somebody hear an older song that they might not have heard in a while, but they came to the luncheon and they're like, hey, I heard that song. It took me back.
Right.
I feel good. So especially just working with Cynthia, just seeing how she came with this idea and just turned it into something big. Like she said, Obama, I'm looking to see Oprah next
week. Okay.
That's what we're talking about. Come on, Miss Oprah.
That's who inspired her. So.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. So, we don't
Brianna.
Want to leave
Brianna
yes. Well, we're thankful for allowing, or thank you for letting us be a part of this show. This is our first year being a part of the Hey Girlfriend Network, and we're just ready to show women that they can be beautiful from the inside out. And, of course, at Dream Girls, it starts with the hair. When your hair is right, you feel confident. My hair's not done today, but it will be fresh for the event. and, you know, at Dream Girls, we have a program. It's called our Healthy Hair Care Program. And the stylists, they pay special attention to each client's needs. If you want to grow your hair, you can grow your hair. My hair was probably up to here to my chin this time last year, and it's grown mm-hmm. down to here. And this is probably within less than a year, thanks
wow.
to the program. So
awesome.
They're really talented at what they do.
Cool.
Nice. Yes.
Well, I think we're going to take a little break and look at Alonzo's video, because he's still here. He's
Yay,
still here, y'all.
Alonzo.
And then we're going to come back with some closing remarks from everyone. We'll be right.
I just wanna be
Let's give Alonzo a nice I'm feeling really good right now,
feeling
y'all.
Good over there.
And I want to make sure I mention my t-shirt. It's a girlfriend thing.
You wouldn't understand.
You wouldn't understand. Mm-hmm. These are t-shirts that are on Cynthia's website. And they help support her causes and her many contributions that she makes. The way she lives her life, it is a lifestyle. So it helps so many other people. So we want to always make sure we're supportive of Miss Cynthia's. She does her networking and everyone's helping everyone. I can see it. I can feel it here today because look at me. And so does anyone have any final remarks while I'm relaxing?
Well, I just want to tell you thank you, Melissa, and Roscoe's Media Center for having us on here. This is the second time I came about a week or so ago, and this is just awesome, especially as a free service. And I've already encouraged a lot of people to contact you to promote their business, promote their nonprofit, promote whatever they want to with you. Mm-hmm. So hopefully a lot more people will be contacting you because this is a great service to get the word out.
Yes.
So I just appreciate it. I thank everybody for coming. We're just going to keep doing what we do. When somebody tells somebody, good news travels fast. Oh, no, good news sometimes travels slow, but with this network, it travels fast, especially with social media. So I'm overwhelmed, so I just thank everybody.
Thank you.
Okay. Cynthia will break down and cry on you.
Right.
I'll cry, too. I swear.
I brought Kleenex and everything. I was like, here we go.
Between the hygiene products and you do the jacket giveaway at Christmas, I do that, too.
Right.
You're a crier. I'm a crier. We need to check our DNA. We're going to do a DNA test up there next time. Right. Next time she comes. We might be sisters.
Right.
Or I might be a little older. I might be old enough to be your mama. But, we have this kinship, and it does not, you do not have to be related to have a special bond with people. It's something about people when you have those similar qualities, like when you start massaging somebody, you just feel a bond, you know. But we're going to go around and let everyone have a last few words. We have about 4 minutes left.
Okay. Well, again, I'm excited about this annual Hey Girlfriends Network Luncheon. Again, this is my fourth year, so Cynthia, I might wear something special for you. I have to do something to culminate four. But and being with this team has just been amazing because it's like a family, and I'm so excited to bring aboard Dream Girls because, you know, hair care and black women go hand in hand.
Oh,
yes. I don't know what we would do without hair care, so I'm excited to see what you guys have in store. And again, you know, hopefully just seeing everybody, if you don't get a chance to see me at the luncheon, you know, my comedy is all over LA, and you know, you can see me August 9th at First AME. So thank you for this opportunity.
Okay, DJ?
Just once again, I want to say, you know, it's a pleasure being a part of it. I want to plug my business one last time. It's Strictly Entertainment. It's a daddy-daughter company. If you have children events, my daughter, DJ Lexi Lex, she's 19. She can handle that. Any adult entertainment you have, like weddings, 40 or 50, if any type of birthday party or high school reunion, family reunion, you can look us up, DJ Strick Facebook or www.strictly-entertainment.com. And the number is 310-200-7408. And once again, I'm blessed to know Cynthia and be a part of this team. It's a real pleasure. It's a pleasure being here on your show as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, and lastly, Dream Girls, we're so excited to be a part of this year's event. We have an exciting hair show. We've been practicing all week. So we have a lot of beautiful natural hair looks if you want to stay natural. Beautiful hair extensions. We actually sell Brazilian and Indian hair extensions at the salon and online at dghair.com. And we're excited to show women how to look like a dream girl.
Check and see if they need one more dream girl.
My hair
done.
No, I'm the one. You're already in.
I need to get Melissa.
I need
to get
you got to come with the waist.
I'm
like a sweep mop. And then Rodney's working. He can't talk, but he's from Holistic Body Works. He's the owner, and he's fabulous. Maybe you can say your number, and I'll repeat it for you.
Okay, I'm Rodney Brunell, the owner of Relief and Belief Body Works in Lakewood, California, 90712. Number is
323-945-7452.
And my goal is to save the world one massage at a time.
Starting with me. Yes, right. I'm a victim, y'all. I'm a victim. And then last but not least, our shining star tonight. We're so proud of him. Yes. Alonzo. Yes. I'm too weak to clap. Go ahead and tell us how you feeling, Alonzo. We're proud of you.
Really
very
grateful,
proud of you.
Really thankful to be here. Thank God. It's been a pleasure being here. Big shout out to Cynthia and the Hey Girlfriend Network. I haven't been there. You know, we weren't good enough at the time to perform at her event. You know, we weren't. We gotta step the game up. So she is no favors for anybody. You gotta really be together. She ain't having it. Big shout out. She's doing great things in the community, and so I'm supporting her. I mean, I'm not the girlfriend, but support what y'all doing. And one day. I'm gonna be at that show next to Obama and Oprah.
That's right.
You know, keeping it real. So it's
been
a pleasure.
Dream happens. Right.
We're all gonna be praying for your success.
Yes.
And if you need anything from any of us, I'm sure the doors are open. I can't do the cute girl video. And I'm a little bit older, but maybe I can play the mama if you coming home later.
We're gonna put you in the throwback.
Yeah, put me in a throwback.
Right now.
After I get my free massage.
Right.
Mr. Rodney. We had a great show. Yes. I don't have time for community events. My board has been so full, but go to the Orange County Fair. And if you download, they have this thing where you download a book. Like if you read a book with your children, they'll give you some free carnival rides. So that's the only thing I'm going to talk about today for the last minute. Go to the Orange County Fair. It's a great way to spend time with your family, and it's low cost. If you get there between 10 and 11 on Saturdays, if you're a senior, you get in for like $2 or free or something. I forgot what it is, but it's a great place to spend your time. The Orange County Fair is a great fair. Big turkey legs and things like that. Oh, my God. And deep fried Oreos.
And Twinkies.
And Twinkies. Right. And chocolate covered bacon. Pickles. I mean, it gets ridiculously good. Yeah. And I'm a foodie. I love food. So definitely I will be going. So we had a great time in our community. We had a lot of good information. This Sunday is Cynthia Billingsley, Hey Girlfriend Network, famous luncheon. And this is her 8th year. And we want to make sure we support her. We want to make sure I get in. So
with
my 10 kits. I'm donating 10 kits.
And I'm very
happy to do it. I thank each and every person that was here sharing this show with me today. And we want to thank the owner of this facility for giving us a voice and letting us have just a little bit of his shine. Thank you so much for coming into this community. And we will see you next Wednesday. I have Vivian Stanso. She is a 67-year-old Olympic swimmer, and she's blind, and she's going to be right here next week. So I am excited to have her next week. I'm looking forward to that. And we're going to call it a wrap for today. We'll see you in our community next Wednesday. Thank you.